I'm not your chief. But I hope.
Outlander is a popular TV series available on the Starz network that follows a married, former World War II military nurse in Scotland in 1945, who finds herself transported back to 1743, where she encounters and falls in love with the Highland warrior Jamie Fraser. However, with season 6 now on the way, fans are already looking into some of the major changes from the book that could be taking place in the upcoming season. First up, further improving Murtaugh's storyline. In the popular book series, Jamie's godfather was described as a short man who was slightly built but sinewy as a gibbon, and weasel-faced. Luckily, the actor behind the character doesn't actually look like this whatsoever, except for the dark eyes. He's much taller, more muscular, and his performance turned a relatively minimal character in the books into a fan favorite in the popular Starz TV series, and saved his life in the process. Most diehard fans of the Outlander novels know that Murtaugh Fitzgibbon's Fraser died in the Battle of Culloden, along with the majority of the Highlanders. However, in this TV series, he was imprisoned at Ardsmuir, became a blacksmith in the New World, fell in love with Jocasta, and became the leader of the Regulators. The change was reportedly made when the show's executive producer, Meryl Davis, recognized the great bond that instantly formed on screen between the three main characters. It wasn't until the Battle of Alamance when Murtaugh finally met his fate and died. So, as we approach season 6 of Outlander, many fans have already speculated that Murtaugh's story could develop even further. Memories of Jamie's godfather have popped up in A Breath of Shadow and Ashes, as early on in the book, Jamie has the sensation of feeling the weight of Murtaugh's dead body on him, leading him to believe that there's an impending war ahead, and nearly 3 decades after the fact, the Battle of Culloden begins to come back to him, also noting to have seen Murtaugh in his dreams. It's entirely possible that Murtaugh makes another post-death appearance, as he did in Claire's dreamscapes in season 5 finale, either as a memory for Jamie or as a flashback to Ardsmuir. Next, Jamie gets a new gig. Upon further exploring the new book that season 6 of Outlander will be based on, A Breath of Snow and Ashes, you'll notice that Jamie might be taking on a new role in the series. In the new novel, Jamie, Sam Haugen, works as an Indian agent, a person hired by the British Crown to negotiate with local American Indian tribes. Jamie's new gig means that he's away from Fraser's Ridge for a large majority of the time, traveling to communicate with the Cherokee tribes. While Jamie's gone, Claire treats the injured members of their communities, continuing the work she did in seasons past. While nothing has been confirmed as to whether or not this will be included in season 6 of Outlander, it seems hard to believe that something this substantial will get left out. Number 3, Claire gets kidnapped. During one of Jamie's trips, Claire is attacked and kidnapped by a group of men, one of which is Wendigo Donner, a time traveler originally from the year 1968. He was in the same group as Robert Springer, Ottertooth, who was played by Trevor Carroll in the show. The Outlander series is known for excessive depictions of such attacks, likely because of how the books are written. Claire is brutalized over the course of 3 grueling days as the entire group physically and sexually assault her. Luckily, Jamie and the men of Fraser's Ridge catch up to Claire and kill off her kidnappers, saving Lionel Brown in the process, who was smothered to death a few days later. This is one instance that the show could certainly do without, but don't be shocked to see it included in some fashion given the history of the hit TV series. Also, Bonnet finally dies. Unfortunately, unless Outlander makes some radical changes from Gabaldon's books, we're going to be seeing a lot more of Ed Spieler's face for at least another season. The Fraser family's arch nemesis strikes again in the latest novel, before he vanishes for good. In typical fashion, Bonnet kidnaps Brianna, Sophie Skelton, and takes her aboard his pirate ship, the Anemone, with the intention of selling her to slavery. Luckily, Bonnet is eventually captured by Jamie and company, and they allow Brianna to choose Bonnet's fate, at which point she shoots him, this time fatally. Bonnet has played a massive role in the TV series, so they could very well nix this part from the book, but at the same time, don't be surprised if the pirate, smuggler, and occasional murderer finally finally meets his maker. Number 5, Fraser's Ridge is home to a throuple. There's no question that the Frasers are most definitely the messiest family in A Breath of Snow and Ashes. For example, Lizzie Wemyss, Caitlin Orion, is pregnant but is totally unaware of who the real father is, Josiah or Keziah Beardsley, and so as a result decided to marry both twins and raise the child as their own. After Jamie handfasts Lizzie to Kezi, she and the twins go to Roger and ask him to handcast Lizzie to Joe, an incredibly confusing scenario that could very well sneak its way into season 6 of Outland. Next up is the Christie family drama unfolding. The story of the Christie family is not exactly heartwarming, easily presenting one of the more tragic, disturbing, and disparaging tales in the series. Malva Christie moved to Fraser's Ridge along with her brother, Alan, and Father Tom in the book The Fiery Cross, but her family's dark secrets begin to spill out in A Breath of Snow and Ashes. Malva grows extremely close to the Fraser family, but once she becomes pregnant, she accuses Jamie of being the father, much to the shock of Claire, when all of a sudden, another tragedy hits. Malva is found dead in Claire's backyard, and even though Claire tried to save the child, both were not able to make it. Claire is then accused of murder and subsequently locked up before Malva's father, Tom, officially confesses to his daughter's murder, though we later find out he, too, is innocent. Tom ends up taking the fall, while the real killer, Alan, Malva's half-brother, is allowed to roam free. Alan also reveals in the novels that he and his sister had been sexually intimate for years, and that she'd been holding his child when she died pregnant. Apparently, he killed her because she was planning on telling the truth to others about their relationship. The dramatic situation comes to a close in A Breath of Snow and Ashes with a young Ian, John Bell, shooting Tom in the back with an arrow. Only time will tell if history repeats itself in the TV series. Also, Roger becomes a minister. Another major plot in the newest novel is Roger, Richard Rankin, settling on a vocation and becoming officially ordained in the Presbyterian Church. In A Breath of Snow and Ashes, Jamie's stepdaughter gives birth to a boy named Henry Christian. However, it doesn't take long for everyone to realize that he's a dwarf, which immediately initiated rumors from the people of Fraser's Ridge. But with Roger rejecting the community's superstitions, he ends up saving the boy's life and baptizing him. He was even quoted saying, "He belongs to the Lord. Trouble him again, ye lot of scabs, and Satan will pop up and grab ye straight down screaming to hell." It remains to be seen whether this entire scene will be included in season 6 of Outlander, but there's no question that Roger's recent development could be a major plot point if it is included. Number 8, Brianna and Roger have a daughter. In A Breath of Snow and Ashes, Brianna and Roger end up giving birth to a daughter named Amanda Claire Hope McKenzie, born April 1776. However, what they don't realize at first is that their daughter was born with a heart murmur, which Claire cannot cure using the current era's medicine. The McKenzies use a gemstone to travel forward in time. Also, Gabaldon confirms that Jem is in fact Roger's son, not Bonnet's, as they both share the same peculiar birthmark on the top of their scalp. Whether or not this iconic scene will be featured in the upcoming season has yet to be revealed, but it wouldn't be the first time the show has altered the storyline, specifically in regard to Brianna. In fact, the actual character of Brianna differs entirely from the books, as in the novels, she's portrayed as being selfish and sophisticated before maturing and becoming more likable. But in the show, fans have grown increasingly discontent due to the portrayal of Brianna, as many describe her as dramatic and irritating, compared to her more believable character in the books. Fans of the books have also pointed out that Brianna and Roger's relationship is a little more hyped up on screen than in the novels. And finally, Jamie and Claire go back to Scotland. Claire and Jamie's time-traveling love story actually started out in Scotland when Claire passed through the stones at Craig na Dún. But years of emotional and physical battles, it appears that the Frasers may be moving on from their North Carolina home. In the sixth book, Claire and Jamie's adventures continue to unfold in the colonies, with the series hinting at a return to Scotland in the seventh novel, An Echo in the Bone. With the Frasers' house completely destroyed by a raid led by Wendigo Donner, who's in search of gemstones to help him return to the future, the Frasers make the decision to finally return to Scotland. Considering that season 5 of Outlander touched on several storylines that were featured in the sixth book, it's entirely possible that season 6 will tap into the events of An Echo in the Bone. So there's a very realistic chance that we'll get to see Jamie and Claire sail back to the Scottish Highlands when the show makes its highly anticipated return. And with that, it's a wrap-up up on the video. Thanks for watching.